my channel. Today I'm showing you guys how to make a quick and easy banana pudding recipe. This recipe, like I said, it's quick, it's easy. However, I do have a recipe where you make it from scratch. I will leave it down below for you guys if you're interested. And also, if you're new here, please subscribe so you don't miss out on my awesome recipes. Hit the bell as well so you can be notified whenever I upload a new video. And if you enjoy the video, don't forget to thumbs it up. Without further ado, let's jump right in. All right, guys, here's what you need. I'm using 2 teaspoons of sugar, 1 teaspoon of pure vanilla extract, 4 bananas, 1 packet of vanilla pudding, instant vanilla pudding. I'll be using 1 can of condensed milk. Also, 1.5 cup of whole milk. 1.5 box of vanilla wafers. 2 cups of heavy whipping cream. And let's begin. In a bowl, I am going to add my milk. Next, we're going to add the condensed milk. Now we're going to add the pudding mix. All right, now you're going to use your hand mixer to mix it. I believe you can use a spatula to mix everything by hand, but I like to use a hand mixer. I'm going to mix it for about 2 minutes. Make sure you get the sides so you don't have any lumps in there, all right? Once you're done, you should have something like this. Place it in the fridge for about 5 minutes. So I'm going to cover it. Next, you're going to take another bowl. We're going to add our heavy whipping cream right in. Now I'm going to add my sugar, my pure vanilla extract. We're going to use the hand mixer again to mix it. Now we're going to mix it until it's nice and fluffy and you have a nice whip. This should take about 5 minutes. Once you're done, it should look something like this. Now we're going to start peeling our bananas. I'm using 4 bananas. I like using the ripe bananas, nice and sweet. Don't use the one that's green, okay? It just doesn't taste as good. I like to use it when it's super ripe. So I'm going to cut them, make sure you cut them almost the same size. Into quarters, I don't know, coin size. Very thin. Mine were a little too thick. Okay, it's nice to cut them thin. Once you're done, you're going to take your pudding from the fridge. You're going to take half of your whipping cream and save the rest for later. We're going to fold it in with the pudding. Once you're done, it should be well mixed, well combined together. Now, we're going to take our
container, whatever you're making your bread pudding in, we're going to place the cookies at the bottom, just like that. Then what I'm going to do is take my bananas, place them right on top of the cookie, because I do like when I'm eating the banana pudding, every bite has banana and cookies. Sometimes you take a whole spoonful of pudding only, or just cookies only, or just bananas only. I don't like that. So I'm going to place the bananas right on top of the cookies, just to ensure when I'm eating this, I get a bite of everything, okay? Now I'm going to take my pudding and just spread it all over the bananas in the cookies. Now with this one, we're doing two layers, so save the rest because we're going to add some more cookies and add more layers of the pudding on top. So save some of it. Now it's time to add another layer of the cookie. I am going to place the cookies all over the top. Then we're going to add more bananas and we can add the rest of the pudding. Now I'm going to add the rest of the bananas right on top, just like that. Just place them all over. I could have added some more bananas, so if you want to add more bananas, of course you can, but I only use 4, so that's it basically. Then I am going to use the rest of the pudding to put that right on top of the bananas. And make sure the pudding cover all of your cookies, because like I said, you want every bite, every cookies to touch the pudding. And yeah, now I'm going to take the rest of the whipping cream or whipped cream, just spread it all over on top of it very nicely so it can look very presentable. All right, just spread it very nicely, and then we can place the rest of the cookies right on there. I use about 1.5 boxes of cookies for this recipe, and like I said, I do have a homemade banana pudding from scratch. I will leave it down below for those who like to make things from scratch. I made it, I think, 2 years ago, so check it out. It's still the same. It just takes a little bit more time to make than this one. This one is quick, easy, you're ready to go. All right, now I'm going to place the cookie wafers around the corners only. You can just cover it with the cookies if you like. What I'm going to do next is basically crumble some cookies and sprinkle it right on top. It just makes it look good. It just makes it look good in my opinion. So that's how I did it. I hope you guys actually try this out. It's quick, it's easy, and of course it's delicious. Why not? Okay, thank you for watching, guys. Be sure to give the video a like for me. Help me out. Give it a like. Thanksgiving, I'm coming through with those recipes. So y'all have to help your sister out by liking this video if you're watching. Just give it a like. Encourage me to make more videos. Just like that. Look how pretty it looks. All right. It looks so pretty. And then you're going to place it in the fridge. Before you serve it, place it in the fridge for at least 10 to 15 minutes. Once it's done, you should be ready to go. You have a nice dessert. Thank you for watching, guys. I will see you guys on the next video. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.